With that said, we ask ourselves, what's a programming language? And understanding this is going to help us understand how we create that content and the different ways of doing so to accomplish a cross-platform approach. A programming language is a way or a combination of commands to talk to a machine, usually a computer. And much like regular languages, there are rules and grammar and patterns that need to be followed in order to communicate with the person who speaks that language. If I want to communicate with someone who doesn't speak my language, I will need to find either an interpreter or do sign language. But for us to communicate, we need to speak the same language. And that's what happens with mobile applications. In order for the application to communicate with the system and for us as developers to communicate with that system, we need to speak the same language. And if we're talking about being cross-platform and having all these different mobile platforms, we will need to speak all of those languages. And programming languages, even though they're not as complex as, you know, our languages, they can take about half the time to really master and get, you know, a handle on. So if you multiply the number of platforms you want to develop on and the number of the number of languages you need to learn, you will realize that you will need a long time to do all of them, or hire people to do it for you. And you know, the chances of finding someone who will speak all of those languages are very narrow. So you will probably have to hire more people to do it. And that, of course, poses a challenge. On top of that, there's something called device fragmentation, which is, out of these platforms that we were just talking about, Android being the one in particular, the system that it runs on is being split into multiple sort of versions of the same system, depending on the carrier, depending on the manufacturer, because, you know, as opposed to Apple, for example, who, you know, builds their software and their hardware, Android is all just software, and then different manufacturers like Samsung or LG will create the actual hardware for that software to run on. Right? Because of that proliferation of devices, you know, we're facing that device fragmentation, because they all run on the same sort of underlying software, but they have differences in the way they access that software. And to us, as content producers, developers, that means that if we build something that is going to work supposedly on Android, it may not work on every Android device. And that poses yet another challenge on top of having to learn all these different languages for BlackBerry, iPhone, Android. With that said, if we compare a web approach and a native approach, native being the approach of building a piece of software in the language of the device for every single device, as you can see, in the web approach, we have a single code base. And then we have different platforms. Here I only have listed Apple, Android, and Windows. And on the native approach, we have every platform with its own code base. And having a single code base means, you know, for those of you who are not technical, like having a single Word document. Having split code bases means that you have, for the same project, three different or five different documents to maintain, and every time you need to make a change, it's like if you had them in French, Spanish, English, and Italian. Every time you have to make a change, you have to go through every single document and change every single paragraph that you want to change for each project or each device. Now, on the website, we have, of course, a wider reach, meaning that with just one language and just one code base, we can reach, you know, a large number of devices because they all understand the same language. But that comes at a price, and it's limited power. You do not have access to all the capabilities of the device by using a universal language. On the native side, we have a narrower reach, meaning that language will only work on that device, that it'll have full power and complete communication with that device. And that in itself, you know, poses the first question that we need to ask ourselves when we're creating mobile applications. Do we need to be on every platform? Or which platforms do we need to be in? Are all of my users on iPhone or BlackBerry? You know, if I remember a few years back that I used to tell a friend of mine, I was trying to convince him to get an iPhone. I was so excited about it. And he used to use BlackBerry. He was a trader at the stock market. He said, that iPhone is just way too slow for me. I need something very quick. So if I am targeting traders at the stock market, why would I create an iPhone application and go through the hassle and the cost and the effort of maintaining an iPhone application and a BlackBerry application? Now, granted, more often than not, you will face the situation of having to be in every platform. And that is when you're going to have these two options at your disposal. Do I go with limited power in a universal language, or do I go with full power, but I create every project from scratch? Reference to compare the two. So if we say that building a mobile site will cost you an average $30,000, and building a native application will cost you an average $30,000 per platform, if you have to be in three platforms, you're tripling your cost. Tripling your cost, tripling your effort, tripling your headaches. You know, it's a no-brainer that, you know, if I need to be on every platform and I need to keep my budget low, I'm gonna go web. But again, I won't have all the capabilities of the device. If my application is going to do something like, you know, editing pictures on the device that requires a lot of power and a lot of, you know, filters to go through, that wouldn't be, you know, that would be possible on a web approach, but it wouldn't give me the same results. I wouldn't be able to accomplish it. So it is not just a matter of budget and time and effort. It is a matter of what I need to do. For that reason, you know, we land on, well, mobile websites are great. You know, if it costs that and I can have it on every device, even desktop computers, I can create a website that looks like this on a desktop computer, on a smaller, like a netbook computer, on a tablet, and then on a mobile device, all for $30,000. If I want to do that with an app, it'll be $90. So mobile websites are just great. You know, why would I go with mobile applications, native applications? But hey, native applications are great too. They have great power. They do amazing things that I wouldn't be able to do on a website, because with an app, I can pre-download stuff and I can have it live on the device and do calculations much faster than a standard website would do. Have it access part of the system that a mobile website will never get access to. So in that sense,